Shalom. I want to give all the praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Rakakwadash. Double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that taught us this truth through the Holy Spirit. And I want to give a special peace and blessings and salutations to the elect. All right, I'm the brother Zion, and Lord willing, this lesson is edifying to feed the sheep and the lambs of Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai. And the title of this video is going to be entitled The Weapons of His Indignation. Okay, the weapons of his indignation. All right, and as you brothers can see from the thumbnail in this video, there's a picture of a Russian nuclear missile. Okay, and the name of that missile is called Satan 2. Okay, and when you read in the Holy Bible, in the Holy Scriptures, okay, and you come across certain verses, all right, the nuclear missiles are in the Bible. Okay, the nuclear missiles are in the Holy Scriptures. All right, something as important as a thermonuclear missile is definitely going to be prophesied, okay, in the Lord's word. Now, whether you believe that or not, that's up to you. The Scriptures say, let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind. The Scriptures also speak about, for what if some did not believe? So you don't have to believe that the nuclear missiles are biblical. We don't care. If you don't want to believe it, then so what? Okay? But one thing we are going to do is teach the 100% truth. Okay? Because we understand that what? The third world war is going to be fought by the way of thermonuclear missiles. So that's definitely going to be prophesied in the Holy Scriptures and the Lord's word, man. All right. And like I said, in the thumbnail, that missile is called Satan 2. All right. That's known as a super nuke. That's known as a super nuclear missile. Okay. And the Lord put the spirit. Hey, the Scriptures say what? He created the smith that blew off the coals and the fire. The Lord created these different scientists and all that to what? To, you know, split atoms and to make missiles so they can destroy themselves. Yeah. All right. See, the Lord, this is his movie. This is the Lord's movie, man. And he has his characters. And everybody's playing their lot. All right, this is Jeremiah chapter 51 and verse 1. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will rise up against Babylon and against them that dwell in the midst of them that rise up against me, a destroying wind. Okay, and that destroying wind is going to come from the ICBM nuclear missiles. Intercontinental ballistic nukes is going to cause a destroying wind to sweep through the land of Babylon and destroy it. If you brothers ever saw that movie, The Knowing with Nicolas Cage, at the end of the movie, they show you the destroying wind. Okay? As a matter of fact, if you didn't see it, all right, you can pause this video right now and go to YouTube and type in The Knowing nuclear missile scene. And it's going to pop right up. You're going to see it. That's the destroying wind that the Scripture is talking about. Okay, it says, and will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her and shall empty her land, because that's what the nukes are going to do. That's what the weapons of the Lord's indignation is going to do. They're going to sweep the land. The Scriptures consistently tell us that the Lord's device is against Babylon to do what? To destroy it. His main target is the virgin daughter of Babylon. It says, for in the day of trouble, they shall be against her round about and against him, Salakia, against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow. And what does the Scripture say in the Apocrypha? It says, his arrows that he shooteth are sharp and shall not miss when they begin to be shot unto the ends of the world. That's talking about thermonuclear missiles. Those are the weapons of the Lord's indignation. It says, and against him that lifteth himself up in his brignadine, and spare ye not her young men, destroy ye utterly all her host. And what do the Scriptures tell us in Second Peter the third chapter, that the elements are going to melt with fervent heat. Okay? And the earth and the works that are therein shall be what? Burned up. See, all of these scriptures connect, man. You know, sometimes when we do lessons, we other scriptures come to our minds. Okay? It says, thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans, and they that are thrust through in her streets. Now we're going to jump around a little bit in this chapter. Okay. Let's go to verse 8. It says, Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. Howl for her, take balm for her pain. If so be, she may be healed. Because right now, what? Babylon is in a terrible state. Financially, spiritually, physically. This place is in a horrible state, man. And as I mentioned in the last video, now, hey, man, we just waiting on the grand finale. Okay, because the scriptures tell us that they're going to hate the whore and make her desolate, roughly paraphrasing, and make her naked and what? Burn her with fire. That's going to be these other nations shooting missiles on this place, man. Yes, that's biblical. If you don't want to believe it, so be it. You don't have to believe it, man. You know, it says we would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go every one unto his own country. For her judgment reacheth unto heaven and is lifted up even into the skies. Because what? People are going to eventually flee back to their own land. Okay. It says the Lord have brought forth our righteousness. Come, let us declare in Zion the work of the Lord of our power. Okay, because the Lord is our power. All right, Yahweh Shimei Shai is our power. He's going to deliver who? The elect of the nation of Israel from these nuclear missiles, man. It says, make bright the arrows, gather the shields. What? Make bright the arrows, gather the shields. So this is war. The Lord have raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. And when you do your research, that's talking about the Russians, man. I've done research on the Medes. That's the Russians. This is a future prophecy. It says, for his device is against Babylon to destroy it. See, the Lord's main focus is this place. It says the vengeance of his temple. So the Lord is going to put that old spirit. Well, he's already done it, man. He's put the spirit on those Russians. Because what? That's the main enemy to America, Babylon the Great. So the Lord is going to put the spirit on Moab, okay, on the Russians, to do what? To destroy America, Babylon the Great, to fulfill his will. Salakia. It says, set up the standard upon the walls of Babylon. Make the watch strong. Set up the watchmen. Prepare the ambushes, for the Lord have both devised and done that which he spake against the inhabitants of Babylon. O thou that dwellest upon many waters, abundant in treasures, thine end is come, the measure of thy covetousness. And that's, see, one thing, you know, these Babylonians, they can't do. They can't deny their end, man. The scriptures speak about what his day is being determined. Okay, he has boundaries that he cannot pass. See, Esau has all of these different futuristic plans and agenda 2030 and what they want to do in the future. Well, the Lord is getting ready to bring you down, man. For Esau is the end of the world and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. Okay, it says the verse 14. The Lord of hosts have sworn by himself, saying, surely I will fill thee with men as with caterpillars, and they shall lift up a shout against thee. He have made the earth by his power. He have established the world by his wisdom, and have stretched out the heavens by his understanding. Which proves that what? Yahweh Shimei Shai is really in control. Okay? That's why the scriptures say he created the smith to blow off the coals in the fire. Everything that's happening is of the Most High. Hey, even the mark. Okay? That's the Most High's mark, man. The Most High gave this man all the technology that he has. But somehow he think he's going to upset the prophecies and trick Yahweh Shimei Shai and trick the potter. He's the clay, but he's going to trick the potter. That shows you the pride of this devil, man. The Most High made the earth by his power. He set you up. The earth is given into the hands of the wicked. Okay? This devil really thinks he's doing something, man. You know? let's see where we at. Let's go to Jeremiah 50 real quick and read a few verses out of there. So, the weapons of the Lord's indignation, okay, are the nuclear missiles, man. Let's see. Jeremiah 50. And let's see what we can get. Okay, Khan, Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 9. For lo, I will raise and cause up to come against Babylon an assembly of great nations from the north country, and they shall set themselves in array against her. So as you can see, Yahweh Shemiah Shai is going, well, he's going to put nations against America, Babylon the Great. All right, so lock here, brothers. It's really hot outside, so I keep wiping my face. The Lord is going to bring these different countries, all right, primarily Russia, against America, Babylon the Great, and other nations as well, Iran, China, etc. Okay? It says, for lo, I will raise and cause to come up against Babylon an assembly of great nations from the north country, and they shall set themselves in array against her. From thence she shall be taken, and she is talking about America. Their arrows shall be as of a mighty expert man. None shall return in vain. And what are those arrows talking? It's not talking about a physical arrow. Okay, like if you watch the movie 300, they were fighting with arrows. It's not talking about that. It's talking about an intercontinental ballistic nuke. That's what it's talking about. Okay, none shall return in vain. What do the scriptures say? None shall break her ranks. None shall break their ranks. Okay, because the spirit of the Lord is going to be in those missiles, man. And Chaldea shall be a spoil, and all that spoil her shall be satisfied, saith the Lord. And I believe the Chaldeans were known for, you know, witchcraft and magic and all of that type of stuff, man. Idols. Okay. Your mother shall be sore confounded. That's talking about Great Britain, because America, what came out of Great Britain, okay? Verse 12, your mother shall be sore confounded. She that bare you shall be ashamed. Behold, the hindermost of the nation shall be as a wilderness, a dry land, and a desert. Okay? This place is through, man. You know, so, hey, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemiah Shai, you know, Lord willing, this was edifying. You know, just get ready to, because right now, people are distracted with the crown royal and everything. But the Lord is now putting the spirit of war, you know, in the air, man. You see this thing was going on with Afghanistan and all of that. So the Lord is putting the spirit of war right back in the air, because, you know, the Lord is a man of war. It said, tells us that in Exodus 15 and 3. So we, you know, prophecies are getting ready to really take off, man. You know, the mark is around the corner. The war is around the corner. Famines and pestilences are here. So everything is shaping up. We getting ready to get delivered. Lord willing, we're of that number, man. We getting ready to get the hell out of here. All praise, honor, and glory is due to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Rekakudash. Double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that taught us this truth once again through the Holy Spirit. And once again, I want to give a special peace and blessings and salutations to the hopeful elect. It's the brother Zion signing off. Shalom.